Hello, my dear students. Myself, Sheetal Mahade. And today, we are going to continue second lesson of geography, which is Let Us Use the Graticule, Module 2. Students, before we start today's session, let's discuss what we learned in Module 1. We have studied how to describe the location of a place on the earth. While describing the location of a place, we need to consider only one parallel and one meridian. We also studied how to describe the extent of the region on the earth. Students, for describing the extent of a region, we need to consider two parallels and two meridians at the extreme ends of the region. At the end, we have studied how to describe the extent of linear features on the earth. Students, for describing the extent of linear features like a river, road, etc., we need to consider the latitude and longitude of their terminal points. Now let's discuss learning objectives and keywords of Module 2. Students, in today's session, we are going to learn important parallels on the earth in detail. We will also study important meridians on the earth in detail. Now students, let's discuss important parallels of latitudes on the earth. There are 5 important parallels of latitudes. Now students, observe the given diagram. In the diagram, the equator is at the center of the earth and it representing 0 degree. Towards the north and south of the equator, parallels of latitude progressively become smaller and smaller. Tropic of Cancer lies at 23.5 degrees north in the northern hemisphere, whereas Tropic of Capricorn lies at 23.5 degrees south in the southern hemisphere. Arctic Circle lies at 66.5 degrees north in the northern hemisphere, whereas Antarctic Circle lies at 66.5 degrees south in the southern hemisphere. The north and south ends of the Earth's axis appear as points. These are called North Pole and South Pole. So students, the equator, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, Arctic Circle and Antarctic Circle, all these are important parallels of latitudes on the earth. Now let us acquainted with important parallels on the earth. Students, the parallel at 23.5 degrees north of equator is called Tropic of Cancer, whereas the parallel at 23.5 degrees south is called Tropic of Capricorn. Now students, observe the given diagram. In the diagram, you can see all places between 23.5 degrees north and south of equator receive perpendicular rays on 2 days in a year. It means this area receives perpendicular rays on 22nd June and 22nd December. The parallel at 66.5 degrees north of equator is called Arctic Circle, whereas the parallel at 66.5 degrees south of equator is called Antarctic Circle. Now students, observe the given diagram. In the area between these two parallels, throughout the year, daytime lasts within the limit of 24 hours, because this area receives slanting rays of the sun. Depending on the seasons, daytime can be greater than 24 hours in the areas between the polar circle and the poles. Students, observe the given diagram. Observe the North Pole and South Pole in the diagram. These two areas receive very slanting rays of the sun. The maximum duration of the sun's appearance in the sky can be fixed of 6 months at the poles based on the seasons. During this period, the sun continues to move in a spiral on the horizon. Students, you have seen in standard 5th that the Earth's axis is inclined. These important parallels arise because of its inclination by 23.5 degrees. Due to the duration and intensity of sunlight, different temperature zones are formed on the Earth. These zones give rise to pressure belts. Students, planet Earth is spherical in shape, so different part of the Earth receives different amount of sunlight. Based on that, three important heat zones on the Earth are formed. They are tropical zone, temperate zone, and polar zone. Students, observe the given diagram. The tropical zone lies between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. This tropical zone receives nearly perpendicular rays of the sun throughout the year, and it receives perpendicular rays of the sun 2 times in a year, on 22nd June and 22nd December. In the tropical regions, summer is very harsh and winter is mild. Students, the tropical zone is also known as the torrid zone. Now let's discuss about the temperate zone. The temperate zone lies between the Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle in the north, and Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle in the south. Observe the temperate zone in the given diagram. These regions receive slanting rays of the sun, so they never receive perpendicular rays of the sun. In temperate regions, summer as well as winter both are extreme. In these two temperate zones, the sun is never directly overhead and the climate is mild, generally ranging from warm to cool weather. The 4 annual seasons like spring, summer, autumn and winter occur in these areas. The North Temperate Zone includes Europe, North Asia and North and Central America. The South Temperate Zone includes Australia, New Zealand, South America and Southern Africa. Let's discuss about the Polar Zone. The Polar Zone in Northern Hemisphere lies beyond the Arctic Circle, and in the Southern Hemisphere it lies beyond the Antarctic Circle. The rays of sun in these regions are very slanting, so this area is very cold throughout the year. Students, the polar zone is also known as the frigid zone. The frigid zones are the coldest regions of the Earth and are generally covered in snow. It receives slanting rays of the sun as this region lies furthest from the equator. Summer season in this season lasts for about 2 to 3 months, and there is almost 24 hours sunlight during summer. The sun's rays are always slanting and provides less heat. Students, now let's discuss important meridians of longitude on the Earth. The 0° longitude or prime meridian is an important meridian. Students, observe the prime meridian in the given diagram. The main purpose of this meridian is to fix the global standard time and coordinate the standard times of different countries. This meridian is also called as Greenwich meridian. This is because the prime meridian is passing through Greenwich City in England. Global standard time is known as GMT or Greenwich Mean Time. Students, in India, we don't consider local time. So, we have a standard time and the standard meridian of India is 82.5 degrees. If the entire country follows the local time, it will be different at different places. And this will increase confusion among people. So, we have a standard time and also a standard meridian. The standard meridian is 82.5 degrees east. In this way, all the countries have their standard times. Students, the 180 degrees meridian is also important. From the prime meridian, other meridians are marked east and west up to 180 degrees. The 180 degree meridian lies opposite to the prime meridian. Students, observe the 180 degree meridian in the given diagram. The international date line is marked with reference to this meridian. Students, observe the international date line in the given diagram. Remember, students, the equator as well as all pairs of opposite meridians form great circles. Great circles are used for finding the minimum distance between any two places on the surface of the Earth. Students, Vatican City is known as the smallest country in the world. It is spread over an area of 0.44 square kilometers. This country is located within Italy on the Italian peninsula. Students, observe the Italian peninsula in the map of Italy. Now observe the latitudinal and longitudinal extent of this country in the map of Vatican City. From west to east and also from north to south, there is no difference in the degrees or minutes of latitude or longitude, but the difference is only in seconds. From this, you will get an idea about the use of the smaller units of minutes and seconds in angular measurements. Now let's discuss what we learned today. Today we get acquainted with some important parallels and meridians. Students, today we studied 5 important parallels of latitudes. The equator is representing 0° parallel. Tropic of Cancer lies at 23.5 degrees north, whereas Tropic of Capricorn lies at 23.5 degrees south. Arctic Circle lies at 66.5 degrees north, whereas Antarctic Circle lies at 66.5 degrees south. So students, all these are the 5 important parallels of latitudes on the Earth. We also studied important meridians of longitudes. The 0° longitude or meridian is an important meridian. The main purpose of this is to fix the global standard time and coordinate the standard times of different countries. The prime meridian is also called as Greenwich meridian. The 180° meridian is also important. This meridian lies opposite to the prime meridian. The international date line is marked with reference to this meridian. Students, at the end of our session, I am giving you one assignment. Please read the lesson carefully and write the answers of these questions in your notebook. I hope this session helps my students to enhance their knowledge about parallels and meridians on the earth. Thank you.